I'm going to be demonstrating the user experience of using PaperCut in a professional organisation such as an engineering firm, an architecture office, a legal or accounting firm. So typically in these professional organisations, the cost of printing is charged to an account such as a project or client account. So here I have an engineering diagram that's going to be printed on a wide format plotter. And I'm going to select File Print. And immediately after selecting print, PaperCut displays a dialog box asking me to allocate the cost to the account. Now in a professional organisation, the list of accounts can number in the hundreds, thousands, or even tens of thousands, often in a complex hierarchical structure. So to make this account selection process easy, PaperCut offers a number of features, and I'll run through those now. The first one I'd like to show is a preferred list. So the preferred lists are analogous to a browser bookmark or favorite, and they're a list of accounts that I've selected that correlate to projects that I may be actively working on at the time. We also have a list of recently selected accounts. In this case, I need to charge the cost to an account for Unity construction, and I'm going to search by keyword. So I type in unit, and it's match Unity construction, and it's an engineering design diagram, so I'm going to charge it to the sub-account for engineering and design. It's selected as my preferred account at the moment, and that means it's in my preferred list because I plan to be doing some more printing over the coming hours or days for this particular client. Some of the other features that we have is we have the ability to be able to add a comment on a job, and ability to be able to change or adjust the costs. So in this case, my administrator is allowing me to make a cost adjustment, and I've actually loaded Mylar film into the wide format printer. So I'm going to select the special charge rate for Mylar film, which adds a small premium to the cost. And the reason I'm doing that is because it's going to be going out on site, so I'm going to write a comment. And if the administrator is also granted access, I also have the ability to control whether this particular print job will appear on the invoice for this account. So I'm now set, and I'll click print, and my job will commence. Now PaperCut in the background has allocated the cost of this particular job and placed it in the database, and the system has been configured to email the accounts person at the end of each month an invoice report in Excel and PDF format, and this particular job will now appear under the invoice section for our Unity construction. And that concludes the end user experience of using PaperCut in a professional organisation.